we continue in penitence. My dear family, let's recall that Jesus' words move our very soul to confess our sins to our Heavenly Father. Jesus' teaching tells us that we shouldn't try to excuse or hide them, but instead confess them in humility, penitence, and obedience. Only then may we obtain forgiveness through his infinite goodness and mercy. Although we should have a daily time for confession, the need for cleansing our hearts is impossible to ignore. As we gather in worship to give thanks for all the benefits we've received, to praise our glorious God, to hear the Holy Scriptures, and to pray to receive all that we need for our souls and bodies from him. So I ask you to join me, wherever and whenever you are watching, to accompany my confession with an open heart and mind as we lift our voices to the throne of grace and confess. Our confession. Almighty and merciful God and Father of all, we have done wrong. We have strayed from your fold like a lost sheep. We have followed the desires that the worst parts of our nature have demanded and demeaned ourselves. We haven't done what you asked and deliberately done things that we regret, and the resulting disease in our hearts is hurting us. Nevertheless, you have promised to forgive even the worst offender when they turn to you in penitence, according to the promises your Son declared to his people. Instead of letting us live in our sinful desires, grant us your presence again, so that we may live a new, godly, righteous, and honorable life for your glory and your purposes. Amen. Grant your faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed, we may be cleansed from our sins and serve you and each other with a clean heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen.